I think it's the 2096. T1, T1. There we go. I mean, it's not possible when doing attempts for this. But Manipulus, I've had it at least twice. It would be time loss, yes. Yes, correct. I mean, I don't know specifically. I mean, obviously it depends on like how you play as well. Because you can obviously play riskier for more time save. Not just a, you know, a flat, this is how likely you are to die to this fight. So I can't give an exact number to that. I'd say a bit higher than one. Like single digit, sure, but higher than one. Generally, yeah, over if you get a step wrong. Well, I mean, it doesn't depend on where the step is, if what you mean by get a step wrong is you do, like, you take an extra step or something like that. Like, some lines can be slightly different, and that's totally fine, but that's not doing something wrong, per se. So, like, for example, it doesn't matter when I turn down there, but it does matter when I turn right. That has to be on the bottom row. But if you're doing something differently that doesn't matter, that's not really doing something wrong. You can sometimes make an error and realign it, but to be honest, doing that is actually more impressive than staying on the path. Like, knowing how to realign and doing that correctly generally takes more awareness. Of what's actually going on. But yeah, no, the Johto games are my favorite. I do have to keep looking. One. Did I just say yes? Oh, you idiot. I'm not supposed to nickname Centric. I didn't use the touchscreen for whatever reason. Okay, if this run actually gets to fork, now I've got to remember that I did that, because that's probably more lag frames, so I should aim a little bit later on the Faulkner clusters. That was a very dumb thing to do there. Good range on Pidgey though. Got the 2 hit. Okay. Okay, that's 10, that's perfect health. Oh, that's not a good start when I want to keep the exact amount of health that I have. And now I'm all the way down to 7 again. For fuck's sake. So now just get 2 useful crits on the next 2 Bellsprouts and get back up to 9. It's as simple as that. Oh dear. Goldenrod. Hit down to 6. I probably will risk a yellow pack. That's a good roll. Alright, I'm gonna risk this. It's favorable to die. Got it? I probably wouldn't risk that if he had good AI, but he doesn't. So even if I miss it, he's a chance to use Hypnosis instead of Peck again anyway. And so that also means if I heal, he's a chance to use Hypnosis and then just put me to sleep. I can probably go instant on this because I think there's extra lag frames. And I crit anyway. Well. World will never know. Alright, can we get a 10-12, Pidgeotto? Alright, that's the 10. Now 12 me. 12! No, that's roost. That's not 12. That's a crit. Okay, cool. That'll do. No. I'm not a collecting kind of guy when it comes to material goods and all. Jesus, that was bold. That was very bold of me. I'd been doing double walk tile to be safe on the blind walk one every run, and this run I just did one randomly and nailed it. Like, I wasn't even trying to, that wasn't a conscious decision, it was just spur of the moment. It was just like, just did the one, I'm like, yeah, that's good, run, go. Very bold. Quick attack this time, will ya? Would have put me straight into Blaze? Nah. Nah, no worries. You're not in Blaze. I won't attack you this time. Son of a bitch. Look at this asshole. Fucking hell. Yeah, Fuck me. So actually, the only time I have ever had to fix the DS was when I bought a, sorry, fix the D-pad was when I bought a new DS. This one. I've never had any of the D-pad or the buttons like fail from wear, from like overuse or whatever. But when I bought a new one, because I needed a new one for a new capture card, The D-pad on this one was not great, and I had to fix it. The select button also didn't work, and I had to fix that. I'm not really sure what I did to fix the select button, because it got to a point where I would, like, I just replaced fucking everything, and then it worked, so I don't know what of the replacement actually did the job. But I know what I did with the D-pad. After opening the shell up, because it was too deep, and so I put... What did I put in there? I took the... I took out a piece of... Oh my goodness, what would you call it? Like, rubber sealant that you would put on Windows. And I cut, like, a little piece of that out and put it in the middle of the D-pad, and it actually made it perfect. Nah, it wasn't cork. It's like the rubber thing. I don't know, whatever it was. It's in there and doing a great job. Do it. Good. Did not want to get poisoned there. I think that would have been a really shitty amount of health. It would have been 14. Yeah, 14 would have been a shitty amount. No, I'm talking about I would have been poisoned. Like, wearing off at 14 would have been really bad. This is still not a great amount, so I'm not in blaze for Beedrill, and Beedrill's probably going to hit me under so that I have to heal before Bugsy, which is annoying. If only Rattata had used Quick Attack! If only! Son of a bitch. Did not crit Beedrill, and it did not miss. That's 17 for Scyther. I'm not healing at 17. No, the Kakuna can't damage you. To start with. The Weedle has Poison Sting and String Shot. straight to QA. Fuck you. Crit. Burn. Nothing. There goes my super. There's a crit. No, no, no. There are two more supers that I pick up before Whitney. It does mean no super for Rival 2, though. I also need to save one of those supers, so it means I only really have one for Whitney. I mean, I can use both of them, it's just really bad if I do. But it is better than dying if it's a requirement. First time I've made it past Bugsy in a while, actually. I haven't been getting very far the past couple of days. Thank God that didn't para. Lick is only a 1 in 64 chance. And so it's very rare to get Lick. I'm just gonna potion for safety, because if he picks water gun again, I just die. In the end, it just ends up being a waste of a turn, but... I'm taking daycare PC. I have to take daycare PC, it's definitely the right decision here. And he fucking picked Astonish, what a dickhead. With no super, double potion doesn't take me to full. I've gotta take daycare PC, it's the right call. Even if I really hate it, it's the right call. Meanwhile, in the background of all of this shit, the fucking... Oh, there we go, thank god. The thing that protects the battery at the back of the DS is like falling off at the moment on my DS. It was just like at this really weird angle where I couldn't get it back in. Like, it's still loose at the moment, but... It was just like half out, and I couldn't get it to sit properly. Just to add a bit of excitement to this Ilex movement. I mean, even if it came out entirely, it'd be fine. No, it's not that the screw hole is stripped, it's that I didn't tighten it properly. Because, I was like, oh, I'll probably have to take it apart again. Last time I fixed the select button. But then I didn't, and then I forgot to actually tighten it, and now it's finally at the point where it's like, ho-ho, I'm free, I'm loose. Ready to mingle. Okay, so I am doing daycare, PC. I have to put Centret in first, so Centret... So I've got to do four, so I may as well just keep Centret. Centret, swap, swap, second. Okay. And that's plus six to steps. And I have to kill Centret on Whitney. Oh, Jesus Christ, mate! Oh my goodness. All right, plus eight. Not where I was expecting to lose steps. Thank you. The bicycle is required for those tweaks, yes. Alright, well, it fell off. I really do not want to crit the mill tank when I need Centret to die. Hopefully the battery doesn't fall out. I mean, it won't, but we still hope. Yeah, I mean, that's what I would have to do, isn't it? How about a crit Clefairy instead? That's much better. Good miss. Oh my goodness. Oops. Fuck! 10. Should I potion or should I Auron? I think I should potion, so I'll do it now. Oh, fuck off. Okay. Beautiful. I preferred to see defense curl or disable there. That was a perfect blaze. Got it. Let's go. That's a crit. Let's go. Okay, that's Q4. Don't mess this up, dude. Don't fucking mess this up. It's been too long since I've got here. I'm not confident. Why did I do that? I didn't mean to do that. That second encounter was a complete waste. I don't know why I did that. Alright, that has Pokerus. I'm really annoyed that I took that second encounter. That was so dumb. Yes, switch, dude. And thunder. What? I know I'm finally on a run. I finally have Raikou and... Yeah, yeah, get excited, blah, blah, blah. Focus on the run that's going up. I'm still just so annoyed I took that second encounter. There was just no need to do that. Spent all that time trying to make sure that I wouldn't be taking a second encounter as much as possible. I'm in a situation where I don't need to, and I still did it. It's like my brain just froze and I just reverted to safety. I realized as soon as I did it as well, I was just like... Why did I do that? Despite the fact that I had to kill Centric twice, this time isn't awful. I mean, I could still miss Gengar 100 times, but... It was a 58 Raikou, I think. My pixies were really good. My pixies were insanely good. Hit straight into Perfect Blaze, and then useful crit on the last as well. Huge. Should I just get Violet Candy? I think I'll just get Violet Candy for this run. I'm not gonna lose this run to failing Triple Tweak. Yeah, Violet Candy is the safe option. Triple Tweak is a bit faster, but you only get one chance at it, and if you miss it, you cannot get it. And you need the candy. So if you miss it, it's just like, well, GG. Alright, Morty is the first of many fights where I have to hit Thunder. Who's excited? Alright, one for one. Let's go. So we're on pace for a 157. Ahead of PB at Morty with this route, and given I skipped Celadon Mart, is pretty fucking big. The lead. Alright, I haven't done this movement in a while. Let's see how many errors I make. Oh, well, there's one. I so want to go. You know I want to go. I'm doing it. Oh, Jesus Christ, man. Oh my God. Oh, brother. So I do double candy here, right? I think that's right. And then I crit. If I didn't go for the thunder, I still would have one hit. Get the range, get the range. No, dude. Lost my full heal. Oh, that was shit. Good. All right. 4 for 4 on Thunder so far. The next one is the big one, though. Well, the big one pre-E4, certainly. Get the range, get the range. Good. Yes, so the next one is Victory Rival Sneasel. The reason it's so big is if you miss the Thunder on Sneasel, it generally uses Icy Wind and reduces your speed, and then you're slower than fucking everything, and then you're boned. Oh my god! God, I'm not getting the fully. Thank you. That's good movement. All right, please hit the Sneasel. I should probably, if I get Sneasel, I should probably double Spark for Alligator. Oh, for fuck's sake. Okay, well, I can't double Spark for Alligator now. Okay, so I used an X speed to try and rectify the situation, so now I'm gonna do Lance without an X speed. Lance without an X speed is actually safer because it means you have to heal. So you heal before the Thunder Gauntlet. And so if you miss a Thunder, you don't just instantly die. Because Aerodactyl outspeeds you, so you have to heal anyway. But it is slower. Nice. Okay. How did I not lose more time? I hit a spinner! What? I would have made up time if I hit the Sneasel. I'm gonna have to waste a fucking full restore if you confuse raise me here, aren't I? Fucking hate to say it. That's why I don't like using the fucking full heal before that. For the people saying, oh, the extra sped F EV from Drowsy, blah, 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 blah. It would actually be really bad if that made a difference, because if that made my special defense higher than normal, that would actually mess up, like, the calcs for the red and the blue in it, potentially, on, really specific scenarios. But luckily, it only makes a difference to your special defense after you get the final level. So it actually doesn't make a difference. Don't you dare. Fuck, this is bad. Mm. Bro, no! Not like this! Not like this! Fuck! Thunder PP is extremely tight during the Elite Four. I at least have to not Thunder 1 now. Oh shit. Good. Because ideally I want to thunder all four of Bruno's fighting mons, but I'm only going to have three left. Okay, at least I didn't miss. So I'm going to have to double Shadow Ball hit him on top. You son of a bitch. What? I should have thrown a Shadow Ball before the X accuracy, in case it did that. Oh no, 93. 93? God, I can't even fucking remember. Could have just done that later. I'm definitely going to heal before Lance. Yes, dude. Actually, I wasn't guaranteed to heal before Lance. I could have gotten confused Ray and then full restored. Thank you. So with the X-Speed, I could have used an X-Speed instead of healed there, and then it's just thunder everything. But if you miss one of the thunders in that situation, you die. But because I don't have the X-Speed, Aerodactyl's going to beat me. So I have to heal for Aerodactyl anyway. So I may as well do it there. So that if I end up missing one of these, I've got 131 health. Good. Okay. I wonder if I just calc the splits wrong. I don't think I should have lost that much time there. That doesn't seem right. Maybe my rival split was just wrong somehow. So I think I should have lost more on rival than I did there. But anyway, as long as I don't mess up from here, I should get record. Because it's all execution from this point. And this route is faster in Kanto by about a minute 50 than my PBs. That being said, it's totally possible that I just mess up. Okay, I'm currently at 4 heals, so I don't need to pick any extras up now. Bro. Simply not the time. Cry. This isn't exactly a new strat, since it's been used since my old run, but it is one of the most unique strats in all of speedrunning. No, don't use Mimic. Come on, Sudowido. Bro! Well, he's got Surf now, so he's going to kill me. This is so unlucky. No, flee with runaway. Do not need the heal. But it's much faster on average to actually sacrifice Sentret by doing that. By skipping double fights, but also, especially on blue, it skips the chance of him using Roar or Whirlwind as well. Like, the fight's Manipt, but it gets rid of him doing that on Manipt fights. So it makes a lot of those fights better. Maybe not a lot, but certainly some. Unfortunately, I got fucking double Mimic Sudowido. So fucking unlucky. All its other three moves are all attacking moves. Those have no guard, so those thunders always hit. Same with Bruno's Machamp. Not like in Platinum, where every fucking Machop has guts. Thank you. Okay, last luck-based element of the run are the three tiles of doom. Everything else is execution. Tough execution, but execution. Here they are. And immediately owned. Very cool. Can only get one encounter there, though. Because there's immunity after the first. That was a really long wait for a blue cluster. A bit of a shame. Just make sure I hit it. Come on. Thank you. Okay, Dark Lumina. Just gotta get red. Don't have to heal, but obviously have to elixir. That was a single heal, so I don't need the extra fully. So close to clicking center on using the elixir there, that would have been tragic. Don't need the dire hit. Thank you. Not confident about that. I think I went too late. I might have missed too late. If I haven't, I've hit the Godseed. Holy shit. The Godseed. So this seed is like almost a minute faster than most red fights are. It's just insanely good. Wow. 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 GG. Oh, wow. Okay, I'll be honest. This entire run, until that last moment, I was thinking, yeah, it'll be nice, I'll get a record here, but I'll still be able to beat that run. After getting the Godseed on red, nah, beating that's gonna be tough now. I reckon I'm happy enough with that now, to be honest. Because you could easily, actually be a minute ahead of that run and just hit a worse red seed and then nothing doing. Oh, that's huge. That's why they call me a fucking genius, though. Look at that. Huge improvement. Fucking almost 2 minutes over the record. Oh, massive. Yeah, like, the thing is, with when I start the run as well, like, you need the hour to roll over to the 12th hour at red, and when I did the soft reset, it was 12:01 and what would it have been? Like, 20 seconds. So if I was more than a minute 20 faster at red, I would either actually have to wait or go back into the clock and reset the clock, which costs another 20 seconds as well. So without getting an accomplishing Godseed at red, like beating that run by more than, you know, 20 seconds, extremely difficult. Getting a 156 without a super good red seed, very, very difficult. A low 157. It's funny that that run had a spinner, but I'm actually really happy with it. But I hit the Godseed on red. I hit the Godseed. My start was actually pretty good, even though I did have to double sack Sentret. My start was actually pretty good as well. That's a good run. It's not perfect, but it's very good. The end. GG.